Well, summer vacations are upon us, but from the toddlers to the tweens, everyone may not be on the same page about what you want to do, where you want to go. And here's a question. What do you do when your teen bursts your bubble, doesn't even want to go on the trip at all? Here to sort through some of those parenting advice, the problems that we're all, many of us are going to encounter, author and educator Dr. Amy Alomar is back with us. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning.
All right, so everything is set, so you think,
right.
And then your teen says, hey, I don't want to go.
Yeah.
What do you do?
So if everything's already set and they have like a really valid concern, maybe they have a job or an internship or an academic obligation, I'd say, you know, consider it. Maybe consider letting them stay off, you know, stay home during your vacation. But if they just don't want to go because they're being ornery or, you know, hormonal, I'd say bring them along.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's important to have them all participate in these family outings and events, right?
Yeah. The point of a family vacation, if you're lucky enough to have one, is to be together,
family.
To bond, to learn about each other.
Yeah.
And so it's important that they're there.
All right, so it's happening. You're going, whether you want to or not. How do you smooth it out a little bit more?
Yeah.
Are there certain things that you can do?
So ideally, before you've booked it, if they've had any say in it at all, even just the smallest choice of where you're going or what you're doing or an activity, that's great. But if it's already booked, don't panic, because they can also play a role in the planning now. So, you know, there's day-to-day decisions about, you know, when you're going to eat, where you're going to eat, what activity you might do, what site you might visit. So they can play a role in that. If you have the finance and you can bear it, you could bring along a friend.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, so yeah. That they don't feel like they're completely cut off from their social world.
Yeah, and yeah. It might be also something that we've talked about in the past as far as the kids earning money and having a goal, and okay, but you don't really want to go, but maybe, you know, your buddy can come.
Yeah. Yeah.
Maybe you just contribute just a little bit.
Yeah, they could. That's a great idea.
Yeah.
And I think also the other things that you can do is if they're being really difficult on the trip, maybe finding some alone time for them. Mm-hmm. You know, what's a thing that they can go off and do and be by themselves?
That's true. I mean, it's really important to have the conversation so you can have a middle ground.
Yeah.
Now, everybody compromises a little bit to have a good time, right?
Exactly.
And how do you convey to your son or daughter, hey, I put a lot of time into this, and I know you're not into it, and you're kind of bashing it. It really hurts my feelings.
Just like that.
Yeah.
You know, it's okay for you to be annoyed with them. It's okay for them to see your feelings. In fact, I think parents oftentimes try to shelter their feelings from their kids, and you shouldn't. Now, you don't want to give them the biggest guilt trip ever and just keep, you know, going on and on about it. Like, state your feelings, express why you're upset or disappointed in them, and then move on and have a good time, and so that they see that. Because a lot of being in a family is kind of learning your role, and
right.
So kind of pushing and pulling, and they can learn, like, okay, mom's frustrated or dad's frustrated with me right now, but now I see them having a good time, so I'm just going to release and do it too. And it's okay, like, be forgiving of your kids, because you are their safe place and you're where they're going to kind of push. So let them see that they can also just roll into a good time too when they're ready.
Right, you were talking about putting it out there, having the discussion, and then moving on. But what if you find that your son or daughter isn't moving on and they're just, I don't know, being kind of stubborn about it? They don't want to have a good time, because sometimes parents find that.
Yeah, and so if at all possible, that's when they need that alone time, that independence.
Yeah.
So, you know, you think about it, like we say time out when they're little.
Sure.
We all need a little time out, right?
Yes, we do.
And so if there's a moment, you know, and if not, just turn on some music if you're in the car, or find a separate place if you can. Yeah, and that's showing them how to cope too. You're teaching them coping skills.
Yeah, because they're going to need to know how to do that down the road. It's best to start it. Try with your family first.
Absolutely. You are their safe place.
Yeah, you're stuck. Together.
Yeah.
So let's make it work.
Yeah.
All right, Amy, thanks so much. I really appreciate it.
Yeah.
Good tips.
Thanks for having me.